This video describes Microsoft Defender Security Settings Management. Across all your onboarded devices, Defender for Endpoint and Microsoft Intune provide a single source of truth for your security policies in both portals. From both, you can create, edit, delete, and view security policies across your entire tenant. This includes Windows Client, Windows Server, Windows Server Domain Controllers, Linux, and macOS devices. As a result, SEC admins can configure security settings in the Defender portal, eliminating the need to switch to the Intune portal and with full independence of the security team. You don't even have to enroll devices into Intune before you can manage security settings in Defender for Endpoint. To be clear, it doesn't matter which agent, Defender for Endpoint or Intune, is on the device. You can manage security settings in both portals, and the same settings are reflected in both places. Simple. Setting up security settings management does require certain permissions. In Intune, you must have the Endpoint Security Manager role. In Defender for Endpoint, you must have the Security Admin role or a custom role that has security configuration management permissions scoped to all devices. Next, I'll demonstrate how to turn on security settings management for the first time in Intune and Defender for Endpoint, and then configure the enforcement scope. The first step is to activate the connection between Intune and Defender. To do that, select Endpoint Security, followed by Microsoft Defender for Endpoint. Then, under Endpoint Security Profile Settings, turn on Allow Microsoft Defender for Endpoint to enforce Endpoint Security configurations. That's it for Intune. Next, configure settings management in Defender for Endpoint. The second step is to configure security settings management in Defender for Endpoint. To do that, you must first enable security settings management. So, on the settings page, select Endpoints, followed by Enforcement Scope. The enforcement scope determines on which population of devices security settings management will be enabled. This has no impact on devices that are enrolled in Intune. We'll consider them enabled and won't change the Intune enrollment status. Turn on Use MDE to enforce security configuration settings from Intune. Then, under Enable Configuration Management, select the platforms and which set of devices to include in the scope. In this case, I'll enable Windows Client Devices and select On All Devices. However, you can also select On Tagged Devices to target only devices tagged with MDE management. Last, if you're using Configuration Manager, you can choose whether you want Defender for Endpoint to coexist with or ignore devices that are already managed by it. When you're done, select Save, and you're done. We'll search for devices where management is enabled, discover them, and enable security settings management on them. Now you can configure a security policy in the Defender for Endpoint portal. To get started, under Endpoints, select Endpoint Security Policies, followed by Create New Policy. Then, in Select Platform, select a platform. In Select Template, choose a policy template. And then, select Create Policy. After that, follow the instructions to configure the required settings. You'll see the exact same security policy reflected in the Intune portal. More than ever, it's easy to create, modify, and deploy security settings policies across Windows, macOS, and Linux devices with Defender for Endpoint. If you'd like to learn more about Defender Security Settings Management, see our documentation on Microsoft Docs. Microsoft Security.